Good evening. So we're going to graph. Let's look at how number 32 is graphed. Okay, so let's do our trick, which is let's look at the trace. Let's say on the xy plane. If you look at the xy plane, then on the xy plane, your z is 0, right? So you replace z by 0. You get z, 0 equals y squared over 9 minus x squared over 4. Okay? And notice that we can solve this for y in terms of x. Do you agree that that is 9 fourths x squared? Right?
Yeah.
You can take the root of both sides, so you'll get y equals plus or minus what? 3 over 2x. So what are these?
These two lines.
These are two lines, right? Two lines. Can you be more descriptive about the two lines? So let's just put our x, y here. Let's do 2z. What will happen here? Your line will pass what point? Your two lines will go through which point?
Origin.
The origin. The slope of the lines are what? One is positive 3 over 2, the other is negative 3 over 2. Right? Okay? So from the origin, you count 1, 2, 3, and go by. This is one line, and the other line is what? Is this the other line? Right? Okay? So this line is y equals plus 3 halves x, this other line is y equals minus 3 halves. Okay, so that's the trace on the xy plane. So this surface, which is a quadratic surface, will cross the xy plane, which is our floor, right? On two lines. Okay. Next, what else? Let's see. If we have the yz plane, what will happen? You set x to 0, right? So you'll get z equals y squared over 9. What is that? A parabola, 1 degree 2 and 1 degree 1. This is a parabola. Can you tell me more about the parabola? So let's say this is our yz plane. Let's put our y here and our z here. How will it behave? Where is the vertex of this parabola? The vertex is at 0, 0 on the zy plane or yz plane. And then it will open how?
Upwards.
Upwards, right? If you want to be more precise about how it will open, maybe you can replace y by 3 or negative 3, correct? And you'll get y equals what? Or z equals 1. Did I do that right, guys? So that is your trace on the yz plane. That's actually the plane that's facing us, right? If we draw our 3D later on, okay? And then finally, we want to look at the trace on the xz plane. So when we do that, we set y to 0. So we'll have z equals negative x squared over 4. What is that again?
Parabola.
Another parabola. Let's see how that will behave. So let me draw my xz plane here. Okay? I have a parabola. Where's the vertex of this parabola?
Zero.
Again, it's at 0, 0. Now, the negative tells me that what? The parabola will have to open
downward.
Okay? What's a good number to assign to x so that I get a 2 or negative 2, right? If it's either 2 or negative 2, the z is going to be negative 1. So that's your trace on the xz, right? A parabola that's opening downward. Now the big challenge is to put all these where?
Yeah, yeah.
Yay! X, Y, Z. Ready? Which one is the easiest to draw? I guess the Y, Z is easiest, right? Okay, so you have something, you have a parabola that goes like this. So that's the trace that's facing us. Then you have xz is a parabola that opens downward, right? So you have something that goes like that, right? Sideways. You see?
Yeah.
Somehow, okay? Now can we see these two lines? On the xy, which is the floor, we will see two lines that are going to be cut by this shape. Okay? for us to see what's happening. Remember what else did we do last time to give us a better picture of what's happening to the surface? Not only do we look at the coordinate plane, what else can we do? We can also look at what? Maybe like planes that cut this, right? Okay, so we call those cross sections or traces again, but on other planes, right? So let's look at z equals k. K is any number, right? So let's replace z by a constant k. What will happen? We'll get y squared over 9 minus x squared over 4 equals k, right? What do you think that shape is going to look like? This will be hyperbolas, right? Correct? Okay, you remember you can always divide by non-zero k, alright? This would be a hyperbolas. Now depending on what k is, right? If k is positive, what kind of hyperbola will you be drawing? It will be on the y, right? Okay? Meaning to say, what do we mean by on the y? Vertices are kind of like on the y. So in other words, if this is your plane z equals k, you expect to draw what kind of hyperbola? Opening how? XY. This plane is parallel to the XY plane, so it will open like this, right? Do you guys see that? Okay? Correct? Because the vertices will be there. So actually, you will have something that looks like that. You see it? Okay? If k is positive, it will open like this. So this is your plane z equals k that's parallel to the floor, right? So you'll see that hyperbola. So hyperbola, vertices, so this is a hyperbola. Let's write it down. Vertices on the y. Why did they put y in quotation marks? Is it really on the y? I mean, it's not really on the y-axis, right? But what we're saying is it's... How do I say it? Did you guys help me explain it? You know what I mean, right? What I mean here is that if you project this down here, where will that vertex land? If you project this, it will land there. That's what I mean. Alright? You agree? Okay? So that's what happens. Whereas, if k is negative, so imagine there's a negative number sitting here. What will happen to this? It will become an x squared over 4, right? Minus y squared over 9, correct? Equals some number, correct? You understand? So you get negative, you make it a negative k to make it a positive, correct? So this is now a hyperbola where? With vertices where? And again, I put x in quotation marks because it's not really going to be on the x-axis. What I mean by that is what? It's like if you project it to the x-axis, that guy will go up there. Okay? And let's imagine this. The x-axis goes like that, right? Towards us, towards you guys. So how will those hyperbolas look? Opening like that, towards you, and the other one is what? In the back, opening the other room, correct? Let me give it a shot. Draw it like this. Opening towards us. And where's the other guy? At this point in the game, I just kind of know what to do already, so I just cheat and continue and finish. The other guy is going to open there. You guys see that? Am I doing a good job? Do you understand what I'm doing? That's the one in the back. Okay? And that's what you call, you see that this shape is what?
Saddle.
It looks like a saddle. But there's a mathematical name for this. What's the mathematical name for this? Let's look at the, it almost looks like what? It looks like you have hyperbolas, right? Two hyperbolas actually. They call this a
hyperbolic.
Don't ask me why. Paraboloid. Kind of understand why it's called like that? So it's characterized by this hyperbolas opening towards us and behind like that. and these hyperbolas that go like this. Okay? In fact, today I have a treat for you. What are these? I didn't even know it, but a friend of mine told me that Pringles are shaped like. Are they? So why don't you grab, I grab one and make two. Get one pass. Yeah. And see if you're convinced that the Pringles, each Pringle looks like a hyperbolic parabola. Just get one or whatever. Yeah. Convince yourselves and see if you can find those traces that I'm talking about. What is enough?
Nothing.
Guys.
Thank you.
And show me. I thought I wanted.
You want the books?
They don't eat it yet. Guys, I want you to convince yourselves that that's a hyperbolic paraboloid. Is it?
Oh, mine looks like that.
So that is the saddle, right? Okay? I'm not sure. Yeah, that's the saddle. And then you have, if you cut a plane through, you'll get your hyperbola that goes like that, right? You see it? Do you see the parabola that's kind of like facing you? There? Right? And then you see the hyperbola that's opening towards me and opening towards you. Get it? The torus. I know you want me to bring donuts, right? Yeah, we should have some problem that involves the torus so we can bring donuts.